Hi everybody, this is Hope from HopeYoder.com and I want to show you how to make In the Hoop this gift card in Craft and Cut software using foil. First thing that you're going to do is open a new page, and I do not have the cutting mat or the grid open at this time. I want to make some setting changes to the grid. To do so, come to Program Preferences, Grid, and I'm going to change my grid to 1/2 inch vertically and horizontally. The next thing I'm going to do is select Snap to Grid, and then OK. I'm going to double click to zoom in closer. Then I'm going to use the Line tool. By snapping to grid, if I snap in the middle, if I snap close to an intersect, it's going to actually sling it right on the cross grid, which is what I want. So I'm going to go four to the left, four to the right. I'm going to come up and click, left click, everywhere I want a line to form. I'm going to come down here to this area, and I'm going to left click here, and then I'll right click to finish. If I fill this in with color, you can see the makings of a gift card. So this is a great time of the year to be giving gifts, maybe money or a gift card to their favorite store or restaurant. So the next step that I want to do is I'm going to change the side so it actually will fit a gift card or a credit card. I'm in Properties and Transform, and I want to deselect Maintain Aspect Ratio. My gift card is going to be 3.85 inches high times 4.5 inches wide, 3.85 wide times 4.5 high, and then I'll select Apply. If you're in millimeters, here's how you can change that so that you can put in these settings. Now I don't really need this grid anymore, so I'm going to travel over here and deselect it. Now it doesn't really matter if this is filled in with color or not. I'm going to work with it unfilled. And I want to make a couple copies of this design, and I can do that by left clicking here and here. And now let's assign some colors. If I come down to my color bar, I can right click on any color and add it to the top color bar for easy picking. We'll do three very different colors. Perfect. I'm going to assign the first artwork blue, the second one green, and the third one red. Now I can select all items, and I will want to center these. So in this icon, click on the drop-down arrow and scroll all the way to the end to find Center Selected Objects. Now notice how these are expanded. Let me show you a little trick. If you'll right-click in the Layers window, then you can left-click on Expand All to close all of the plus marks. I'm going to go ahead and select Applique for this shape. So I've selected Shape 2, and I'm going to travel up here to select Machine Applique. I'm going to leave this preset at 4. For the width and the density, I'm going to select Applique Extra in the tack down stitch, which is the second stitch. Let's show you a preview. Is I would like to change that so that the tack down becomes a zigzag stitch. To do so, select zigzag. I'm going to leave everything at default, and then I'm going to select apply. Now, when I do the slow redraw, it's going to give me a placement line and a tack down line, a zigzag, and then it'll go right into the satin stitch. Great. Now for this particular exercise, I don't really want to digitally cut my shape because I'm going to add some foil. And where I'll find the foil, well, first let's go ahead and just save this design. So I'm going to go under File, Save As, and I'll call this a video credit card. And I'm going to save it first as a WAF file because if I need to make changes, I want that native, editable, working file to be saved. Now I'll go under File, Save As, and then I'll change this to the format of embroidery machine I'm going to use. Perfect. Now that, let me close this screen out, and I'm going to open the design that I've just saved. We're going to open this, and now notice I have, let's get to 3D view. I have the placement line, and I have the tack down, and I have the zig satin stitch. But I want to take this design, the placement line, and duplicate it. And if you didn't quite see that, let me zoom out. If I take color number one in the layer window and I select copy, it's going to duplicate this. It's not actually copy, it's a duplicate. Now it throws it off center. So I'm going to select everything and come back up and select center again. And I actually am going to want two placement lines. And the reason for this, whoops, is color number one. Let me hide these to show you. Whoops. Color number one is going to be my placement line where I'll lay the fabric. Color number two is actually going to be the tack down line, where I'm going to lay my front fabric, my back fabric, and my front pocket. And I'll show you that in a bit in the PowerPoint. And then I'm going to do a zigzag stitch and a satin stitch. So now I would just File, Save As, and I would save this again. Don't save over your WAF file. Let me do that again properly. I'll go File, Save As, and I'm working with a PES file. So I would save this here, and I'll just put 2 for version 2 and save it again. Now the next step is to add the foiling, and we're going to find the welded lace square in the Hope Yoder library. This is a library which contains, when you purchase Craft and Cut, it's blank until you fill it in or go under File, Import Hope Yoder Designs, and when you purchase Craft and Cut, there was a CD inside free of 256 SVG files. You'll find that CD and go Import and add them. Once you do that, they'll populate in the pink HY Hope Yoder library. I'm going to scroll all the way down to the very end to find Weld Repeat Design. And let me color this something lighter. Now this design I want to be a little bit bigger than my credit card case, and I will center these all again. Perfect. Notice how that fits. Now let me transform that so it's just a little bit bigger. Actually, that looks pretty good. I need excess for trimming, so when I look at it, I really like the way that looks. So this size, I'm going to run through Save to Cut. I'll select, now I do have the embroidery design, but we don't have to worry about any of that when I run this through Save to Cut. File, Save to Cut. I'm going to be using a Brother Scan and Cut, and I'm going to be using Heat Transfer Vinyl, so I'll make that selection. I'll select Next. This is going to populate the suggested cut settings to put my blade, standard mat, speed of 3, pressure of 0, and it's going to give me a video, and it lets me know how to place the material on the mat. I'll select next, and let's just name this video CC, and I'll put HTV for heat transfer vinyl, and I'll save that. And then what happens is I have a template. The template is at 100% because it's smaller than a sheet of paper. All of those settings are populated here, but what's really nice is it shows me my actual design size. So I would probably just add 1 inch to the height and the width and cut my material from that. And now I'm ready to cut out the design. This is what the design looks like. And here's some pictures of me cutting the adhesive, adding the foil, heat pressing it, and then I've got this design. The next thing I'll do is I will hoop a mesh stabilizer. Color number one, after the placement line, I'm going to tack down the square of fabric that I foiled, and then aligning on the wrong side, which you see here, I've actually used tieback material, but you can use any material. And notice I've used Embroidery Perfection tape to tape it in place. Color two is a tack down, and after that you'll trim. But before you do this, actually I've just folded a piece of fabric in half, and right along this line is the fold line so that I can make a pocket to slip in my credit card. When I'm done, it's going to look like this, and we've got a satin stitch, and you can add a little Velcro dot, and I've just sewed on a pretty faux button just for decoration. And because this is your front piece, notice the pocket is the same color and it's not foiled, and it gives a beautiful decoration.